So hello, my name is Tony Richardson, and one of the discoveries that we have come to in our close proximity of the phone, I shall speak into you loudly words such as these things. What is a rumiverse? A rumiverse to a human being. A human being's rumiverse is their bedroom. And now it is a Gaia constellations. I decide that it should just be pinpoints as a dimension, and then also the proportional planets to determine the proportional size of each mammal, fish, bird, and humanoid creature, like cat, dog, giraffe, rhino, all of them. And then we do another dimension with the nodes. The node above each thing is best labeled as a heat sensitor on top of each planet for surface pressure. Surface pressure will teach us where everything is laid. And that will teach us where everything is laid on a flat entire rock. And now we have to think about the afterlife here. In the afterlife here, what we're gonna have to do is make a physical plane into an astral plane and enable a spirit to actually enter into another body. And the way that could be done is the spirit is actually entered into the universe at a disclosure agreement. It does not cause time space to stop. It will not stop time space, what we're doing. Okay, is it gone? Good. Now, the next thing in the node in the rumiverse is also white clouds that we walk through, and they create mystified mists, and it rains like plagues, and waters flood the earth, and waters flood the gas, and the gas makes the atmosphere, and then the meteors from every realm determines the realm of the receiver of the spirits, and their DNA, and their technology analytics, and their statistics, and then they reframe them back into a dimension that we analyze with a line and determine the length of each life. By determining the length of each life, we know when the astral plane will gain new communities, names, nomenclatures, helmet trees, and then the helmet needs to be invented. The invention of the helmet, oh my God, Tony! The invention of the helmet would also come with, of course, the idea that we can dissolve and time dilute time durations. We also need a way to eat time-space as well as understand the code and the code inside of it. So all we need to understand is that we need to understand that every number all equal infinite. And then there is more. We can really do this. Yes. No, I'm saying that as God. Wait, I just sniffed up my nose. I've got an idea. And it's gonna have to be that we're gonna have to make infinite concept over concept, and interdimensionalize that into one dimension per square. And that will just be an interdimensional currency television show that's based off of royalties that we end up making as infinite beings being the clone and the clone of our own idea. And that's another one. So who is ready for the world? They are not ready for this. If they are civilians and normal people, they are not ready. And this right here, of course, is more of what we're going to talk about. Because if you realize the way the world works is that they are doing something impossible every single day. Because the world is so complex, so hard. When is each person really there? Inside their head, looking out their eye. When are you finally lucid enough to look through your one eye and go, hello, my name is, and yes, I'm looking through my eye and looking nowhere else. I'm not an android. It's like being human. So I am not as strong as God. I can open your eyes. Tell me. over. Roger, sir. Another thing to understand is that we each, as classmates in school, were allowed to play commander games as officers. And as officers and generals and captains. And play a mind game in space with our little movements, like a flinch on our finger, cycle through the options that you select, and then the body or the brain or some part of us actually plays that game. When are you lucid, looking through your one eye? I never know where you're looking. What am I supposed to do about getting you into heaven? Heaven! I don't know what you're looking at. I don't know where you are. I'll chase you anywhere with time to spare. Let me share this whole new world with you. I know. Maybe the most dangerous word to ever speak. What an iconic film. But do you know what else it teaches us? This song is called The Circle of Life. The Circle of Life. It is a circle. Does that mean as a spell? Because it's a circle, we could circle our children. We circle our children. And then what? They just live a loop. Live a loop? But I know that sounds right to y'all. Live a loop and how that functions for the way you see things. But I see things like a human being. I see through my eyes at all times. So the expiration date on the finite human may be limiting each other every day. What we are is reincarnated beings. We are the afterlife for some creature. Someone died and then was reincarnated, like a bug turns into a man and a man turns into a horse. We are all to the death to the next life animal. Death to the next life animal is one way. That is one way. But you know what that really takes? Is still teleportation, time travel, and species varianting. So XYZ. XYZ. When, where, what? When, where, what? In the circle of repetitive motion. This is better right here though, right? For all those. Infinity. Isn't that what we all crave, is this infinity? Never pay Tony. Law in America. The most dangerous two words you'll ever see are right there. The most dangerous words in the galaxies.
circle of life. We live, we die. We live, we die. But is it always repeats? Is it always a repeat? We spare a hope. And spare a faith. And spare your life. Spare your soul. Spare your whole existence. And then go down the alley with your ball and strike a strike down their fucking nose while they try and replace human beings with robots and aliens and computers. I'm trying to save the human race. My name is Tony Richardson.